is all kind of things and what is the features of RDBMS. So this will be checked out. Okay, right. RDBMS is completely this concept and this model was okay. So this model was introduced by. The German scientist Mr. E. F. Kord. So he's one of the scientists here. Okay, Mr. E. F. Kord. And he's also one of IBM employee guys. He was IBM employee. So he was introduced this model. Okay, he was introduced this model. Okay, so in database here. And in this model, whatever we said here, okay, so what he was going to be saying, when we are using RDBMS model or is RDBMS softwares, okay, so when we use here, so the data can be stored. Okay, the data can be stored. The data can be stored. Okay, so in the form of, so in the form of tabular format, guys, in the form of tabular format. Okay, so in this format, the data can be what we can say organizing, otherwise data can be stored. Okay, in the format of table. So here table is nothing but we all of you know guys here. So we can design your table. So table is nothing but it's simply a collection of rows and columns. It's a collection of rows and columns. And a row is nothing but, simply we call it, a row is nothing but, it's a group of or collection of fields or columns. Okay. It's a collection of fields, otherwise we call it as a columns. A row is nothing but collection of fields or columns. Okay, values. And these are table and row and okay. What is a table? It's a collection of rows and columns. What is a row means? The row is nothing but a collection of columns values or else column values. Otherwise, we can say column fields. Also, we can go to check it out here. Okay, now right. And here we can go for to if you want to call a row. So row different manner we can call a row or we can say record or we can say is a tuple. We can say it is a tuple. So row, record, tuple all are same guys. Same meaning will come out. Okay now. So same meaning. In the same to same, suppose we have a column. So column is nothing but what we can say guys here, column. Okay, or else we can say it's a field. Okay, so column or field. Otherwise we can say here, attribute, or else we can say here, these are all our same. So now in RDBMS, when we want to organize your data, so compulsory we should go for data can be organized in the form of tabular format. And a table is nothing but it is a collection of rows and columns. So in such a format, data can be stored. But here, the people saying that it is a relational database management systems. Okay, so why it was called as relational means, the reason is what now, what he was said here, the Mr. E. F. Kord, So whatever the data can be organized in your relational model, the data can be organized in the form of table. And here, like this, you can go to any number of tables. Any number of tables you can go to create, or any number of tables can create. Okay, can create in RDBMS database. Okay, create in your database. But what you were saying here, but every table, okay, but every table should have a relationship with an other table. So like this, we have to maintain our data. So that's why we called as a database is called as a collection of interrelated information we set. It's a collection of interrelated information we set. Okay. So because of reason, every data, whatever we inserted in the format of table. So like every table to table, we must have a relationship. Every table to table, we must have a relationship. For example, I said to you, like I'm putting here customers. So customers' information, which was related to orders, which was related to products. Okay, now it was related to products. So these are all are having the relationship. Customer table, orders, and products. These three tables compulsory should have a relationship because customers are ordering products. So these three are having relationships. Like we can say one more example. For example, we have a student. Okay, students and courses. Okay, students and courses. Okay, or you can say registered. Okay, you can say registers. Suppose student details, okay, course details and registration details. Student registered in which courses? What kind of courses are available? Okay, so how many students they selected so and so courses? And how many students they registered. Okay, so this kind of relationships will be having here. In the same pattern, if you want to go for the one more thing is what now? Okay, so we said here, department details, and we have a the relationship with the employees. So department, employees, okay. So this is what we call as a one type of relationships. So like this, any number of tables you can create and store your data in the format of table, but every table to table should have a relationships. And how many types of relationships, okay, we can made it in between tables. We can create in between tables means there are three types of relationships are supported by your relational model. Okay, so the RDBMS supporting all types of relations. All types of relations, and we have a three types of relations are there, so that all are supported by your relational model. That's why it is a purely relational dependency model. It's a purely relational dependency model, and that is the reason Mr. E. F. Codd, he was given the R stands for relational. Okay, supporting all types of relations here. All types of relations. Okay, so those are what now here. So I think we all of you listening this relationship, like one-to-one relation, okay? Like one-to-one relation, like we have your one-to-many relation, or a many-to-one relation, okay? So the next one we have your many-to-many relation, many-to-many relations, okay? So these are the three types of relations which are supported in your relational database model. Okay, management systems. And now let me come out here. So that's I'm giving you a definition one by one. And later practically I will show you in our classes. Okay, when we started SQL language. So at the time I will show you how to making relationships in between tables. Okay, now right. So now here one-to-one. One-to-one means one-to-one relation is nothing but what now here? Observe. So a row in a table. A row in a table is associated with a row in an other table. For example, there are so many examples you can say, like what you can say, guys, here. What is the example here? Okay, we have your employee. So employee is having the unique ID number. Okay, now. So like we have here, the, one more example if you want to see. Suppose nowadays we have a user. Okay, now. So user is having, okay, unique user ID. User ID. Okay, so this kind of any example which is called as a 1-to-1, okay, or 1:1, we call it as that. Okay, right. In the same pattern, 1-to-many relations. What is 1-to-many relation means? Here, a row in a table, is associated with, with many rows in an other table. Okay, now. For example, let you see. What is the example for this thing? Okay, simple. The example is called as, for example, yeah, student is there. A student can select many courses, right? A student can select many courses. So he can select here, what we can say, many courses. So a student can select many courses. That's all, no? Like, so suppose you can go to say, a university having, okay, he's having many colleges. A university is having many colleges. Okay, now. So like this, this kind of examples will be come to us. And the next one is called as here, many to many relations. Okay, next, many to many. What is a many to many means? Here, many rows in a table. Okay, many rows in a table is associated with, with many rows in an other table, Okay, what kind of examples will be come to here? Means the example is, we can say many customers, okay, they can select many products. Or many customers, they can select many products. Okay, like here, many students, okay, they can select here many courses, many courses available. This kind of examples we called as what now comes under many to many. Like so many examples, we just go to create it now. So these are what now. That means whatever we said here. When we are storing data in the format of tabular format, and the kind of tables, you can create any number of tables in your database, but every table should have a relationship with another table. Okay, now. So like these are the tables. Customer is a table, and order is a table, product is a table. So these three tables are having relationship with each other. Okay, so customers, order, products, compulsory have a relation. Like students, courses, and registers. So students registered courses, departments employ. Okay, now, so these are kind of data we can store under relational model. That's why it is called as a relational database management systems we call. Okay, now, relational database management systems we call as here. And this relational database management system, okay, there are so many different types of the futures it was going to be designed by people. Okay, so what kind of futures we will see it here. And now let me come out here, futures of so one by one future I will discuss, and every future practically I will show you in my classroom. Okay, now? So every future I will show you in your classroom here. The futures of, okay, RDBMS. So let you see what kind of futures will be supported here. Okay, we will check out. First of future in RDBMS model guide here. Okay, first one is called as it. So, the main thing is what? It must be stored. Stored data in table format. This is, okay. So any RDBMS product, in real time, any RDBMS product, which will be stored data in tabular format. So other than tabular format, so we cannot store data into RDBMS. It's a compulsory, we should store it. So second one is what now? Okay, RDBMS, second one is what now? It's supporting high security, guys, here. Okay, supporting high security. Okay, high security levels. Okay, how it was supporting high security means here with the help of, okay, with the help of, there are two modes we have it here, authentication mode, okay, authentication and authorization mode we have here. We have a authorization mode. So with the help of these authentication authorization modes, okay, so we are going to be connecting, or you are going to be working on your Oracle. For example, so authentication is compulsory when you have to go for connecting your Oracle. Compulsory, we should require username and password. Without username and password, you cannot connecting to your Oracle database. So when you want to work on Oracle database, first we need to connect to my server, my Oracle database server. First, I need to connect. So after connectivity only, okay, we can go to communicating and we can go to performing our operations. For example, let you see. For example, I will go for my Oracle. So I'm using my S++ tool. Okay, suppose I just open here. So my S++ tool, I'm opening here. Okay, so when it was open, right, can you see the guys here? When I want to open my SQL+, so this is 19c version we are using, so 19.0 version we are using, and see here, so enter your username. So it was going to be entered username here. Okay, so compulsory we should enter username. Suppose my username is a default user system, compulsory we should give it. And immediately it was asking password. Suppose I'm going to enter some password, I entered. And now see, if you entered the wrong password, it was immediately showing as what now? Invalid username or password, logon denied. So invalid username or password, logon denied. So that means compulsory, it will be going to be verify your username and password. Okay, now compulsory, it will be verified your username and password. If anyone is wrong and wrong entry we are given here, so immediately Oracle will give okay, error messages and invalid user or password name. So let me see guys here, I'm going to support it here. And my password is, so I entered password. Now you can see, when I was to enter my correct username and correct password, okay, then here connecting to here. So connected to Oracle database 19C Enterprise Edition, and release version 19.000, and the product version is 19.3. So now successfully you connected. Can you observe? Successfully you connected, and this works, okay, going to frame as successfully you connecting to your Oracle. After connectivity only, okay, then later the user can perform any kind of operations in the database. Otherwise you cannot perform. Okay, now, and here whatever the password I'm going to enter, the password is not visible. It's not visible, but it will be typing here. So your password is type here. Your password is typing, but it is not visible to us. It is not visible to us. But so many students are confusing here. Sir, my password is not typing here. Okay, my password is not typing. Okay, somebody, they confused here. So don't confuse. So your password is typing here. No problem. Your password is typing here. Okay, now, right. Suppose you want to see my password is, what is my password here? If you want to see, let you have to connect one more time. So then if you want to see your password, the username slash, and here I want to give my password type here. So my password, if you want to give in the same line, okay, system is a username and slash, and this is password. So your password is not showing. Can you observe? Your password is not showing, but password is typing here. It's a typed here, but it will be not visible to us. Okay, it is not visible to us. Suppose you want to see your password. Then you can enter like system slash tiger. So now you can enter what it was saying here.
authentication and authorization.
It was connected. So now it will take it. Suppose you want to see your system and the tiger is a password. And can you see, observe here, successfully it was connected. Can you observe here, successfully it was connected. So whenever you want to view your username as well as password, if you want to view, then you can enter by slash and you can enter like this. And you will be getting some message connected. And if you enter in such a way, okay, in such a way, if you enter, so then it was, so username is showing us, okay, username is showing us, but it doesn't show your password, but password already typed. So now what you understand, guys, here, when we want to working on Oracle, compulsory authentications are required. Without authentications, you cannot connecting to your database. Understanding now? So this kind of security, high level security, we are going to having in this Oracle. Okay, so that is one of the best future the Oracle is having. Suppose my username is what now, and my password is what now. Okay, now, right. So this is one best feature. And what is authorization? Authorization is nothing but permissions we are giving to user to perform your operations, like a grant permissions, revoke permissions. Okay, so that's what it is, and that we will be see in our classes. Okay, and the next one is, okay, RDBMS is going to be supporting, guys. So the next feature, RDBMS is going to be supporting here. Which kind of supporting means? It supported all the things here, like data, okay, integrity mechanism, data integrity mechanism, okay, and data indexing mechanism, data indexing mechanism. It's kind of the features are supporting here, and later it was going to be okay, to reduce data redundancy problem. Data redundancy and data inconsistency problems, we can go to avoid here. Inconsistency, okay, we can avoid it here. So data redundancy and inconsistency problems, okay, how we can go to avoid means by using of one of the technique that is called as the normalization techniques. Okay, we are going to be using to avoiding redundancy and inconsistency problems. And later we can go to say, guys, here it's very easy to manipulation. Okay, so easy to manipulation your data, or manipulating, you are manipulating data by using of, so by using of one of commands are there, like DML commands, what we have it here. With the help of these commands, okay, with the help of DML command, okay, we can go to easy to manipulate. I don't want to write a big program. No, I don't want to write a big programs. I'm going to simply, we are going to be taking DML queries from your SQL language, and we can easily manipulate whatever and wherever you want to manipulate. Change your data, you can happily change your data. And later after that, we can go to, so easily we can access your data. Okay, we can access your data with easy manner. Okay, so easy to retry data from database. Okay, I don't want it any iOSINT programs, any Java programs. I don't want to write for retrieving the data purpose. Okay, now, so retrieving data from database. Okay, with the help of one of DQL or else we can say DORL commands we are going to be using to get this data. Okay, now. Right. And later, one more thing is what now, guys, here. Okay. So fastly retrieving data by using of data index. Okay, that we can go to say it here. Data indexes, use it for what purpose here? Fastly and quickly. Okay, fastly getting data. Okay. So whenever you want to retrieve data fastly, okay, to access data, okay, fastly accessing data with the indexing mechanism, okay, that is one feature we can say. And later here, when you want to share your data, okay, data sharing, okay, how can you share data means with the help of your one of the concept of views are there. By using of views concept, we can share our data. So that is one feature. And the same to same, and it was going to be supporting, okay, it was going to be supporting here, Okay, transaction, supporting transaction. Okay, so with the help of your acid properties. Okay, so acid properties. So your acid properties are nothing but, okay, acid properties are nothing but A stands for atomic, C stands for consistency, I stands for isolation, D stands for durability. So with the help of acid properties, whatever the transactions we are performing in the database, that every transactions will be so accurately and consistently it will be performed. So this is one of the best features in this RDBMS. And later we are going to be taking care. Okay, there's so many other things we have here, like the supporting. Okay, supporting all types of relationships. So I already said to you, supporting all types of relationships. Okay, now. So like what is Unona? So like one-to-one relation, comma one-to-many relation, or else a many-to-one relation, many-to-one relation, and third one is many-to-many relation. So all relations, sir, it was supported by your RDBMS model. And later, it was so many the concepts we have introduced in here, so supporting like, for example, what we can say, operators, yes or no, so many other operators, like your functions, like your procedures, okay, not so many concepts we have it here, okay, like clauses, okay, so like there's so many topics we have it here, so every topic is having some specific reason, okay, this kind of things will be supported here. Okay, now, and here, one more thing is what now? So, in this RDBMS, so any RDBMS product, whatever it is there, whatever it was there, so it's supporting one language here. Okay, supporting one language here. The language is called as SQL. So, SQL is one of the languages guys here whenever you want to communicating. Okay, communicating any relational database management systems. Okay, when you want to communicate here, compulsory SQL language, compulsory, we should use it here. And SQL is one of the language which will be used to communicating with any RDBMS product, if any RDBMS software. Okay, now, right. So this is what some future, okay, what is what we can go to check out in this RDBMS, right? Now, later, somebody is asking to you, can you give examples of an RDBMS, okay, product, sir? Or else we can software. Okay, if anybody say examples on RDBMS products and software, if anybody asks you, then these are the, some examples of your okay products. I will give some products to you. Let you see. Oracle. Okay. So like we can say SQL Server. Okay, Oracle. Like we can say SQL Server. Okay. Like we have some products like MySQL. MySQL, like we have your DB2, like we have your Sybase, like we have your Informix, okay, like we have your InGreen, okay, like we have your Teradata, like we have your PostgreSQL, like we have it here, MaxDB. Okay, now, so these are a few, okay, and RDBMS products we call guys here, so like, excellent. Okay, now, so these all are comes under RDBMS model and RDBMS model database software we call. Okay, now, so these all are we called as RDBMS products or as RDBMS software we call. And these softwares are, we are going to be mostly, nowadays I already said to you, any project nowadays we have to develop in real-time industries, any Java projects, any .NET, any database, or any Python, any what we can say PHP, any type of, okay, so the technologies we are using, okay, like DevOps, Informatica, yes or no, so everywhere testing people, even though testing people also needed, okay, SQL language queries when they want to go for automation testings, yes or no? So these kind of things, that means almost every, in every technology, in every platform of application, compulsory, they're using RDBMS products, okay? And I already said to you, almost in everywhere, okay, can you remember in my, what you can, in demo classes, we explained to you, okay, in demo classes, we explained to you, everywhere we are using, okay, okay, RTPMS product, like so many different domains and categories we discussed here. Okay, did you recall once in our demo sessions? Once you can recall our demo sessions, so I said to you, so these are some, okay, so where you have to use in the databases in real time is whatever we said here, banking, airlines, universities, telecommunications, financial, and manufacturing, HR management, sales, and hospitals. So these are all the way in the, all the way in the, all the domains, in the, all the categories of fields. So almost the RDBMS databases are we are going to be using. So, and the different organizations are using different softwares. Some organizations are using Oracle. Some organizations are using SQL Server. Some organizations are using MySQL. So it's a depending on their client projects, client requirements. Okay, they are going to be using the particular RDBMS products in their, okay, in their companies, right? Okay, now, right. So this is what we can go to out here. So these are the one thing I was explaining to you. So where you have to using your databases in real time world, right? Now, so these are the complete, okay, what we can say, the futures as well as a few examples of RDBMS products we are going to be having here. And in this, one of the RDBMS product we are learning, guys, here, that was what is now Oracle. That was what is now Oracle. So now Oracle, now come to the first software you are learning, okay, in this course. Now we are coming to this course. What we are learning, sir? Yes, we are learning our one of the software. So that means I think you understand here. So every software is having its own features and its own syntactical specifications. And one more very, very important thing in this case, what happened here? So many people, they're thinking that, okay, sir, in Oracle, okay, like we are using some SQL Server, okay, like we are using some MySQL, yes or no? So, sir, these are all are same or different means. Here, one thing I have to tell to you guys here. Here, in every software, in every database software, common language that already said to you, SQL is a common language of any RDBMS database. Okay, SQL is a common language of any RDBMS database. Okay, now any RDBMS database, we can use the SQL language. Okay. But the thing is what now here, very important thing is what now? Only in this SQL language, okay, we are using SQL language in Oracle database to communication purpose. We are using SQL language in SQL Server database for communication purpose. We are using SQL language in MySQL to communication purpose. But in this, what it will be same means, so only SQL standard queries, whatever it was there here, the standard queries will be same. Only SQL standard queries will be same. Only SQL standard queries will be same. Okay, now standard queries only same. So, and remaining things will be same. The remaining things there, it will be changing, guys, here. Okay, where it will be changing means. So, that what it was, that maybe, yeah, remaining things will be what now? Same. But the remaining concepts, the remaining concepts will be different as per the software, syntactical, that means the syntaxes and their specifications. Syntaxes and their specifications will be changed. Okay, will be changed. Suppose as per Oracle software. As per Oracle software, now your syntaxes, specifications will be changed. As per SQL Server software, then your syntaxes, specifications will be changed. Understanding now? Your syntaxes and specifications will be changed as per your, what we can say, SQL Server software. Now, as per your MySQL software, so what it was going to be happen here, observe. So as per SQL Server software, then your syntaxes and specifications are different. Okay, so will be changed. So same to same. Suppose if you want to go for MySQL also same to same as per the database software. So your syntaxes and specifications are or will change. That's why what it was happening, guys, here, what it was happening. So when you come to SQL standard queries, like DDL queries, DML queries, insert, update, delete, select, these queries are almost in every RDBMS product, it will be standard queries. So standard queries are nothing but what now we cannot change. It will be standard, and the standard was ANSI format will be defined. Some standard queries in your SQL. So those standard queries almost in every RDBMS databases will be same. But the remaining things will be changed. Like remaining things means, for example, operators, data types, clauses, okay, some joins mechanisms, subqueries mechanisms, okay, so partitions, indexes, locking mechanisms. So at the time, so concept may be same, but the way of implementation code, syntax is nothing but coding part that will be different. For example, simple logic you have to understand. Suppose I have to check it here. Okay, suppose we have a, okay, Java, one technology we have it here, right? So we have a Java. Okay, we have a .NET. Okay, and we have a Python. Okay, we have a Python. Can you tell me, guys, here, three technologies are same or different? Come on, guys. Java, .NET, and Python. These are same or different?
Different. Different.
Where it is different? There are all our technologies. There are all our languages. There are all our procedural languages. Sir, but where it is different, sir? Means, yes, the way of syntaxes are different. The specifications are different. And every programming language is having its own data types. So Java data types, can I use into .NET?
No.
Come on, guys. Java language data types, can I use into .NET? Yeah, .NET cannot understand because .NET is having its own predefined data types, its own data types, which are supported their compilers. Java data types are supporting Java compilers. Okay, so .NET related code and syntaxes are supporting by .NET compilers. Okay, so like this, what it was going to happen, guys, see, okay, every language is having its own syntactical specifications. Maybe concept is same. For example, suppose in this we have a one of the concept is array. The same concept will be there in your .NET also. But guys, array, okay, fine. The concept is same. But the various difference means the way of syntactical specifications are different. So array can be defined in one way, okay, now in .NET in another way. So the syntaxes will be different. Maybe concept is same concept. The presentation implementation will be different here. So same thing I'm telling now. So when comparing to any RDBMS database softwares, okay, maybe SQL standard queries are same. When you come to remaining the whatever the topic wise or conceptual wise, whatever it was there, that was will be changing as per the syntax and as per your software. So as per your Oracle software, we are going to be having some different syntaxes and specification. As per SQL Server software, having something. As per MySQL, having something. So that's why the point is what now? In this, all databases are, okay, SQL language queries will be same, but the remaining things on concepts, everything will be same, but only the syntactical specifications will be different. Okay, now, so yes. So that's why what it was happened. You should learn it. If you want to know, sir, in Oracle, how we can go to use which language, means language is SQL only. So Oracle SQL language, you have to learn. SQL Server SQL language, you have to learn. MySQL SQL language, you have to learn. okay na, so that's why here what the people will say, if you're coming to Oracle course, then we are saying that Oracle SQL, what we are saying that our language name is what, Oracle SQL. If you go to SQL Server classes, then those people are saying what now? SQL Server SQL. If you go to my SQL classes, then here they will say my SQL. Okay, SQL. Okay, now so that's why in real time also, whenever you want to go for any position of database jobs, they will be clearly mentioning what now. So what you want data? So you wanted Oracle SQL developer or SQL Server SQL developer or my SQL SQL developer? They will be clearly mentioning in this, or your position, your role, whatever it is. Okay, now so maybe you look like all are using same language. Okay, but the way of syntax will be different. The way of presentation will be different. That's why what you want to learn, that you have to carefully decide. Okay, now, so don't confuse here, because Oracle SQL is a different, except queries. Except DDL, DML queries, the remaining will be changed. The concept-wise the same, but the way of presentation is different. That point I'm telling, carefully observe. SQL Server SQL is different. MySQL SQL is different. Understanding my point, now? So this point should be remembered, guys, here, whenever you want to choose your databases. So which database SQL you want to learn? Oracle database SQL you want to learn? Or SQL Server SQL database you want to learn? Or MySQL SQL database you want to learn? So that was first you have to fix it. And one more thing is what now? But one common point is what now in this all, standard queries. So whatever we are using standard queries, like a DDL queries, a DML queries, a DQL queries, a TCL queries, and a DCL queries. These are the five languages standard queries will be almost in every RDBMS will be same. Okay, now that is point. It was remembered, guys, here. Okay, right. So now, okay, now like this. Now we are learning what now here. We are learning Oracle database. That means we are learning Oracle related SQL language. Okay, no? So our own specifications, Oracle SQL syntaxes, Oracle SQL specifications will be learning here. But standard queries ways, yes. Suppose you have a good knowledge in SQL standard queries in Oracle. So that will be, you can help us in SQL Server also, you can use. In MySQL also, you can use it. But only I'm telling SQL standard queries. So once you have a good idea on SQL standard queries, these standard queries, okay, can be used in any other database softwares, because those are common things. Okay, now, but the remaining concepts wise, a lot of changes will be occurred. Okay, now, right, that point should be remembered. And now we will be started. Okay, what we are learning now, we are learning what? Oracle. So we are learning Oracle, and our version is 19c version. We are learning in this. Okay, now, so right. So now, here are the right here. So in this Oracle, okay, so, okay, what is this Oracle? And as for some information, I think you people get some idea as of now. So Oracle, simply we can say it is one of the an RDBMS. Okay, so what I want to say here, so now we can observe, this is our first session of our Oracle. Okay, so now I'm giving here, so this is Oracle session. Okay, Oracle session one. Okay, so we started 10/08/2021. So this is Oracle first session. That means before the sessions are completely DBMS related things here before. So now here Oracle is the first session. Okay. So any students are there, don't confuse guys here. This is your first Oracle first class I'm starting here. Okay, now? Right. So now, right. Now we will discuss about what is Oracle and Oracle. Okay, now? What is Oracle? Okay, and Oracle database software, how to use and how to installing your Oracle software, how to download your softwares, how to communicate in connectivity, user creations, how to create a new user's password, these all the things we will be discussed right now. So first thing is what now? Simply we can say Oracle Okay, Oracle is an RDBMS. Okay, Oracle is an RDBMS product or RDBMS software. Okay, from Oracle Corporation. Oracle Corporation. Okay, so Oracle, okay, is an RDBMS software from Oracle Corporation, and this software was introduced in the year of 1979. In 1979, okay, the first version of your Oracle, okay, it was introduced by Oracle Corporation in 1979. But guys, here, okay, what is the main purpose of this Oracle? Okay, what is the main purpose of this Oracle means? Yes, Oracle, the main purpose of here was storing. So storing data, okay, data storage, data in permanent manner, permanent means where you have to store, means permanent means hard disk. Okay, permanent means what now? Hard disk. Okay, so here are two types of memories we are going to be using, okay, in our Oracle server. One is called as a instance memory and one is called as a database memory. So what is instance and what is database, we will discuss. But one point should be remembered, whatever the data we are storing in our Oracle database software through Oracle database software, through whatever we are going to be storing, the data can be permanent. The data can be permanent, and until unless your data is not deleted by manually, okay, so the data will be permanent and lifelong. Okay, until unless the user has to go and delete it, then only data deleted. Otherwise, the data will be permanently it was having in your hard disk. So that kind of storing your data in permanent manner, and here not only permanent storage as here, and one more very important thing is what now, along with the storage, okay, along with what now, what we have here means the security. Okay, so security is also one of the major factors why the people are using databases, and not only storing. So storing data not only permanently here, along with permanent storage, we will go for to check and to maintain security also. Okay, now understanding my point now? So this is what we called as guys here. This is what we called it. The main purpose of Oracle is what we can say, data storing permanent manner, okay, along with security. So security and storage, these are the major two things, okay, in any RDBMS databases will be provided here. Okay, one is a permanent storage along with your security. Okay, so this is what we called. And this RDBMS database or Oracle, suppose you need to work on, we need to work on this Oracle. Okay, we need to work on, okay, work on Oracle or Oracle database. Okay, Oracle database. So definitely, first of all, we need to deploy that. First, we need to deploy. We need to deploy. Okay, we need to deploy. So your deployment is what? Before you want to store your data and providing security, whatever. But first we need to deploy our Oracle software. So deploy your Oracle software. So what is the deployment? Deployment is nothing but installations we call. So first we need to go to install. First we need to install Oracle software in your system. And after installation, then we need to work on that. But whenever you want to deploy here, okay, when you have to deploy your Oracle software, so when you want to deploy here, which kind of operating systems are supported means here, almost any operating system you can go to using that. Any operating system is supported. Okay. So like we can use Windows operating systems. Okay, now like we can use Linux. Okay, like we can use the Unix. Okay, like we can use Solaris. Okay, Polaris. Like we can use Mac. okay, so OXD, OXD, OSD, okay, so many, almost maximum every operating system will be supported in your Oracle. Because of reason why, sir, means your Oracle is called as, it's a platform, okay, it's a platform independent product, guys, here. It's a platform independent software, or platform independent, we call it. So how you are learning, your Java is a platform independent, .NET is a platform independent, so Python platform independent, how you are learning, your Oracle is also a platform independent product. So that's why any type of operating systems you can use while when you want to deploy or installation time. Okay, na? Right. So now this is what we want. And later guys here, okay, so now we need to see how to installing your Oracle software. Okay, so the installation process also I will show you clearly. Okay, so how to installing your Oracle server software. And before you want to install your Oracle software, first we have to go for how you want to download your Oracle software from your websites. Okay, so first we will see how to downloading. Okay. Okay, first we have to see how to download. Okay, how to download Oracle. Okay, Oracle 19c. Okay, software. Okay, so this is first question. And later, how to install Oracle 19c software. Okay, now? So what we say here simply, Oracle is an RDBMS software from Oracle Corporation. In 1979, it was introduced here. And the purpose of Oracle is to store data in permanent way. Yeah, permanent storage is nothing but hard disk. Okay, we are using hard disk memories and along with the security. And before you want to store data in permanent manner by using of Oracle, so first, what we want to do, guys, here, first we need to deploy Oracle software, and the deployment statements here, any operating systems you can use it. So these are what now the minimum, okay, any operating system you can use for deployment or installation purpose. Because of reason why, sir, any operating system supported means, sir, because your Oracle is a platform independent product. Okay, no? Platform independent product. So now before you want to completely work on your Oracle database, first we have to go for how to downloading Oracle 19c software from your websites. Okay, that procedure I will tell you. And later, after successfully we download it here, then we can go to installing your Oracle 19c. Okay, so these are the two things. And after successfully downloading, installation will be completed. Then we started our work. Okay, so now, okay, but how we can go to see this, how to download. That we will showing in the tomorrow session. So tomorrow session I will show you guys here. But here up to the part, okay, the what we can say, the topic one, the file versus DBMS, whatever we said here, the complete notes, okay. So the complete notes, my people are sharing to you today. Already your Google Classroom is okay. This notes, so file versus DBMS. So this complete, okay, running notes as well as main notes, okay, the both running notes as well as main notes, the both my people are sharing to you today through your Google Classroom, okay, through your Google Classroom. So this part will be, okay, complete notes, you will be get it. And we started, okay, today, so about Oracle software, okay, what is Oracle and Oracle installations, downloadings, and now you can work it. So we are going to, in the second part of this Oracle software, we started today. Okay, now, so file versus DBMS. Okay, so whatever the complete notes and notes also, I will show you how the notes is I'm going to preparing me myself. So it's notes also very neat and clean diagrams. Okay, and once I will check with your notes, so you will be, I hope that you will be satisfied or not, you just tell me. So for example, introduction to DBMS. So this is your first part of main notes. This is a main notes, not running notes. This is the main notes, and I prepared in a simplest format and simplest manner. I was prepared here. So when you see this notes, you will be easily understanding without having any confusion, guys. Okay, na? So now introduction of DBMS, whatever we discussed, what is data, what is information with along example diagrams, everything. And what is the data storage, right?
So data storages and the book and flat files, advantages of books and the flat files. Okay, now, so your flat files, disadvantages, we are discussing data redundancy, inconsistency, integrity problems, okay, data retrieval problem, security problems, indexing problems. And later we're discussing database, DBMS and DBMS software. So what is DBMS? The small diagrams. Whenever we require is a diagram, I will give diagram also clearly, and the types of databases. Okay, can you see the types of databases we discussed, like OLTP, OLAP databases, and this is a small diagram, OLTP and OLAP database, okay, and later DBMS, and why DBMS, okay, so the collection of entities and whatever it is, advantages of DBMS, later DBMS models, that's a hierarchy, networks, and relation, so hierarchy model, some diagram, and the drawbacks, okay. So network model, some diagram and drawbacks. These are all are outdated, but your idea purpose, I'm giving this note. Okay, na? Right. And later we started RDBMS. Okay, RDBMS complete information and the futures of RDBMS. Okay, na? And the table designing, what is what. Okay, na? It's a symbol and a relationship. Whatever we discuss, relationships up to, okay, these three types of relationships. Like this, every notes, that means main copy. This is called the main notes, main material. You have a clear cut diagrams, clear definitions, examples, everything will be have it here. Okay. So notes, I will providing perfectly the main notes. Running notes mean that is explanation notes. Okay. You don't want that much need of running notes. Okay. But main notes is very neat and clearly my people. Okay. And I prepared here. So you just take it now. Okay, now, right. And running notes also every day I'm sending. So just for your topic running, whatever the explanation purpose, and this is your main material. So every topic wise, once your topic is completed, you will get a main material. Okay, now. So I already said to you. So one is a running notes, one is a main notes. The two notes you will be get. And running notes each and every day after class, after session, you will get a running notes. That is everyday process. But the main notes you will get once your topic is complete. Okay, now? So these two things I'm sending here. Okay, so and this is main notes. So today you will be get this main notes, whatever this just now I showed you. This is main notes. And what we are going to be, okay, what we are going to be explained here, this is called a running notes. So this note also I'm going to sharing to you. So running and main notes today you will be get through your Google Classroom. Okay, now? Right. And Google Classroom already, Narish IT management people are created already. So I hope that, okay, you people are, okay, got it or not. So if you are not get it, you are, okay, you are not get it. So immediately contact to Mr. Srikanth sir. So Srikanth sir is there here. So these number already they forward to you. So please talk to him and as soon as possible, you will get that Google Classroom. Okay, now, so once you received Google Classroom link, then everyday notes, material, softwares, video installations, everything you will be get it to Google Classroom notes. Okay, now, so all of you clear now? So about your notes, about your running notes, and tomorrow in our classes, I will show you downloading of 19C software and installation of 19C software. Okay, now, okay, after the installation successfully done, let me start your practicals. Are you clear? Okay. So, and okay. Na? So, Google Classroom, okay, as soon as possible, take from Mr. Srikanth. Okay. The number also there now. So, maximum take it here. Right? Yeah. So, now I stop it here. So, if anybody, okay, any queries are there in your Loo link and Google Classroom or subject, whatever you can go to, okay, give it here. Okay. Your queries, give it. I will respond to you. Yes, Kuldeep. Kuldeep, okay. Now, so Kuldeep, why are you switching to Oracle here? Already SQL Server you are working now. I think SQL Server Oracle in the working style, okay, maybe syntaxes are different, but same working procedures. Then why are you switched to into Oracle? Okay, you are not at a development role. So you're at what? Maintenance role? Okay. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, so whatever you are sent here, okay, whatever you're expecting, that all are going to be happening in our course. So we are learning indexes, okay, tables and partitions. Yes, we are going to learning in this. Definitely, this will be help you to switch to PL SQL developer. Okay, right. Yeah, so who are got it Google Classroom link? So please accept that invitation. Accept that invitation. Okay, na? After you are accepting, then you will be added into Google Classroom. Okay, na? You will be added into Google Classroom. Okay, right. Yeah, in mobile also you can. In mobile also you can. Yeah, Arshav, Python. So I said here, Python, .NET, Java, okay. So SQL queries are same, that will be useful for any technology. Okay, na? Right. Definitely, Sushma, once you're learning this course, definitely you will be learning complete SQL and PL SQL and dynamic SQL. So in Oracle, we are learning three parts. SQL is a one part, PL SQL is a one part, and dynamic SQL is a one part. Okay, na? Right. Rajesh, don't worry. I'm talking. Okay, today I will talk it. Okay, today I will talk to him, and I will inform to you tomorrow. Okay, na? Right. Okay. No, Rajesh, I will talk to him. I will talk to Mr. Srikant. And later, I will give complete Google Classroom link as well as Google ID also. Okay, na? Don't worry. So, Pramod, it is a 60 sessions of course, Pramod. I think you are a newcomer today. Already, my schedule is also I was given. So please once check out here, anybody having the schedule doubts are there. So your clear schedule I already informed with the first, okay. So in initial classes only, my schedule, complete schedule I was given. So if anybody having any schedule related, so please guys check out this Oracle 19C course schedule. So check out if anybody having any doubt. Okay, Pramod, take it on. Software installation, I will show you, Jagdish. Okay, no need go for anything. I will show you, okay, na? So I'm showing and I'm giving the video also. So based on that video, you have to install, okay? Right. Definitely. But Ravi, 2013 pass out means, Ravi, you have to keep it, experience on that, definitely you will be. Okay, if you're keeping, otherwise 5, okay, so 5 plus or 6 plus, yeah, definitely. But that much stuff you have to practice it and do some hard work. Definitely you will be succeed. Okay, na? Right. Yes, Sagar. Yes. For developer, which developer? For developer means so many developers are there near us. Java developer, Python developer, .NET. Database developer, which you wanted. developer means present in your front end side. If you go, so Java, Python, .NET, these are the best things for your developers to make your career. Okay.